Happy Saturday. I am in my laundry room with Catherine. Say good morning, Catherine.
Good morning, Thomas.
With the wig cap on. Turning on the camera, we are so tired, but Catherine's going out this morning. I'm staying home. And she is trying out my new washer dryer for the first time. I told you guys that the plumber came the other day to set her up. And so she is now functional. And Catherine is going to wash the first things in here because I'm a nice sister. So I wanted to show you guys what it is like. And we're going to learn how to use her together because I don't really actually know. Gonna do, you want a quick wash, I think.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know how to use this because I just turned it off. Clearly. Okay, quick wash. Hold to start. And then things are happening. She locked. Wish she had a light. It's just dark. Things are happening. I want to get an exercise bike, guys. Anybody got any recommendations? What bike should I get? I want to put it in this back laundry room. Over here-ish. Like, a little bit. Like, it might be blocked by that door a little bit, but it's on wheels. You can go right here, be kind of out of the way of these two doors, right in front of this window-ish. You can either go this way or, like, long ways. Long ways obviously would block these doors a little bit more. But I don't know. I just want a bike. So we'll see. But which one should I get? I want a Peloton, but it's too expensive. So I might.
Expensive.
I might Peloton hack it. No, I'm probably going to Peloton hack it. Probably. Especially since. Like, come on. How much am I gonna use it? Like, I have to be smart about this purchasing decision because I've spent a lot on this apartment already. So yeah, things are washing. We'll be back when it's time to put in the dryer. Ooh, it already smells good, like nice laundry soap. So
yeah.
Okay, y'all, so it's finished washing and it was just singing, but I missed the singing, sorry. Smells freaking delicious. And we're putting her in the dryer. And first time having a front load washer in this house, but I am following the tips and tricks I learned on YouTube to keep her open so you don't get the whole mold inside. Okay, and we can, normal, not quick dry. Okay.
2 o'clock.
True. Hey guys, I have not checked in quite a while. Sorry, I'm looking for my phone, which is on the charger. Duh. I have not checked in quite a while, and it is currently 8 p.m. I have had the most boring day for YouTube, I'd say that. But I had fun because I. Had some time in my apartment by myself for the first time since I've even had this apartment. Like, my sister went out, brothers are out, so it's just me. I'm actually watching, I watched the new episodes of the game on Paramount Plus. That was interesting. The series is different, but I liked it. I did like it. I think it takes some time to pick up and I am curious about where they're taking it, but I like it. I like seeing like the old characters again in these new roles. There's nostalgia, but it definitely looks and feels like a new and different show. So I like that. I'll watch that. Right now I'm watching And Just Like That. Child, if you guys have not watched that yet, spoiler alert, I'm about to talk about it. But I have not tweeted in quite some time. And episode one of And Just Like That, which is the spinoff of Sex and the City, and the remake and the reboot, is cringy. And it's because of Miranda. And it's so funny because they really brought it into this century and with the issues that the world is facing now with COVID and the racial unrest and racial insensitivity and just general insensitivity as well with gender pronouns and then also openness and talking about sex and things like that. I thought that was really interesting. But Miranda left her during COVID, left her job as a lawyer to go back to school at Columbia to get a master's of public health so that she could become more of an activist. And then day one of her class with her black professor, she assumes that the person is not the professor, even though because she saw a picture online instead of keeping her mouth shut. And then comments on the professor's hair just because she's seen her with a short haircut on the website. Honestly, I don't know if I was just personally triggered because I change my hair so much, and people, obviously, I feel like, especially working in corporate and working in startups, white people comment on my hair more than black people. And like, obviously, I love a good comment from a fellow black girl saying, "Oh girl, your hair looks nice," or "Ooh, yes, new hair," or whatever. But the white comments always made me feel uneasy because it's never sometimes it's not complimentary. And when it's not complimentary, I don't know how to receive that, because you want to comment on how it's different, but you're not necessarily saying that it's nice or that it looks good. And that's just shady. We know shade. We invented shade. We know shade. So, not to get into my stuff, but I feel like that's why I was triggered, because I change my hair so often. So when I hear her say, "Oh, on the website, you have this short hair," it's like, okay, and today she has braids. What does that have to do with anything? And it was so cringy because she just kept going and commenting on all these inappropriate things. And at like 1 second I'm like, I'm impacted by her comments, and then in the same vein I understand where she's coming from, because later on she makes a comment about wanting so badly not to say the wrong thing, that she said all of the wrong things. And in the current climate, like, it's hard to know what the right thing and the wrong thing is to say in certain situations. And no matter how good of a person you are and how much you want to say the right thing, you might end up saying the wrong thing. And that is just what it is. When it comes to assuming people's gender pronouns, you're probably going to say the wrong thing. When it comes to being a person who's trying to support people of color and thinking that, "Oh, I had black friends," or "Oh, I protested during George Floyd," or "I did all those things," like, they're nice, but you're saying something to prove that you are with the community, and then sometimes it can be taken like the wrong way, or it could feel like forming. Many Nigerians know, you know, forming or acting or giving your resume just to prove that you are not a part of the white supremacist part of this country, for lack of a better word or term. So yeah, it's hard. And so I appreciated that. I thought that was a real part of the show. And it really got me thinking and cringing. It got me tweeting, y'all. So I was like, "Oh Lord, I am cringing because she just kept going. And where she went wrong is commenting on the woman's hair. So what? She could change her hair. She could have braids. She could have a short pixie cut. She could wear a long 30-inch wig. She can be blonde tomorrow because black women have that versatility. And I think that white people need to stop being so shocked by that. Like, I'll have a different hairstyle tomorrow. I have a different hairstyle in 30 minutes if I get, when I get ready. And that, I love that. That's me. That's what I do. That's what black women do. That's what we can do. That's black girl magic. So get used to it. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, rant over there. The episode is really good. Obviously, I've been seeing spoilers online. About the end of the first episode, and Carrie should have called the ambulance and all that stuff. I'm like, that's really annoying. So I kind of knew what was going to happen, but I think the show is pretty good. And if you haven't seen it, you should, and you're a fan of Sex and the City, you should give it a watch. And we finally have black characters, Nicole Ari Parker and this black professor that Miranda's in her class. And it's nice to see. So I like it. Anyways, ranting, chatting, giving you guys vlog contents because I already did a vlog yesterday, but I'm really just trying to do this Vlogmas thing and do it right and wear the badge of honor of getting through it. So I'm happy that I had the opportunity to just chat with you guys today, even though I didn't go out or do anything in particular. This is my life. These are my thoughts. This is what it's like to talk to me and chat with me and get to know me a little bit. So hopefully you find me interesting and want to be my friend. Okay. Shut up, Mary. Anyways, besides watching TV, which I will continue to do, I'm also, today should have been a hair day. But I'm probably not going to wash it, but it's very dry, so I'm probably going to just put some leave-in and some oils in her. And then, since I'm fairly alone and I really want my table up, I'm probably going to build my Amazon table that I mentioned to you guys before, that white table that was there before, but in marble. It's been here for a couple of days, so I want to finally build that. So we got some action today. Besides just watching Catherine do her laundry this morning. I also want to show you, let me not forget, I also want to show you guys the gift bags from the Transform the Hustle event that we went to on Thursday night. Because those gift bags are really, really nice. And that's it for now. So. Okay, y'all, table is built. That thing had me sweating.
But I did it. I did it. I don't know why I'm like so happy that I did it, because I've built this table before and it's actually really easy and perfect assembly for one person, but I haven't put together a table for myself in a while. Catherine's always here to help me, so I wanted to do this one by myself, so I did it. And as promised, now I'm going to show you guys the gift bag from the Transform the Hustle Black Office Holiday Party. So here we go. It came in this wood stack bag. I have no idea what wood stack is, but this piece of tissue paper came with this cookie in it. It's actually an edible cookie, and we were asked if we wanted it before it was given to us. They baked in Bushwick. I thought that was interesting. I said, yeah. I've had gummy edibles before, not really baked goods, but I'm gonna try that. We also got an Essence magazine with Megan Thee Stallion on it. She looks stunning. And honestly, this goes really well with this table. So I might set something up. It's gonna be temporary, but I'll leave it there. This I thought was cool. We got a Popple Instantly Share Anything, which is like a keychain which shares any info of any phone. So if you're networking, great for networking, to send somebody your Instagram really quick or a digital business card. I thought that was really, really cool. So yeah, all the instructions on how to activate it. So we got that, and it's a cute color too. I'm so excited about these last two things. We got Gabrielle Union's new book, You Got Anything Stronger. I've already read We're Gonna Need More Wine. Loved it. This one is Stories by Miss Gabrielle Union herself. We're gonna need You Got Anything Stronger. I was gonna buy this. It came out in September, and I was telling a coworker about this and was totally gonna buy it. And I got it for free. So super exciting. And then last but not least, and definitely the thing that makes the bag the heaviest. Ooh, did I drop? We've got it. It's a husband wife thing. Dwayne Wade's book. It's a picture book about his life. This cover, stunning. Husband and wife, stunning. Love that. And this is so general. Like, you guys need to see how large this book is. This book is huge and so generous. Also looks super good on this table. So probably going to do something like this for right now while I figure it out. I also need to go get my record player. That's going to stay here. But yeah, I love that. And I thought the bag was empty. What else did I drop in here? Oh, I totally lied. It's not empty. That was the thing making it heavier, but we also got a Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cream, and this is the full size, the 1.7 fluid ounces, which is awesome because face cream is always good. And then I keep mentioning my childhood friend Hilda, who is part of Transform the Hustle. She works at Shea Moisture, so we got some Shea Moisture Coconut Hibiscus Curl Enhancing Smoothie, the goat of natural hair products. So that's what we got. All right, so now that was the full gift bag. So yeah, I'm so glad we went to that event. I'm still raving about it because it was awesome to just see so many young Black professionals in one space, mingling, networking, especially after the 2 years of COVID that we've had at this point. It was nice to, I used to go to events like that all the time because I headed an ERG, which is an employee resource group at my previous company. And those kind of events are, I always leave feeling so good and feeling like I've met so many new people and made some really great connections. So I'm so proud of her and her organization for putting on something like that. It was so impressive and so well needed. Anyway, guys. That's today, very chill day, but to be honest, I enjoyed myself, just chilling in my apartment, watching and catching up on TV. I built my table, yeah, so it was a good day. Hopefully you guys enjoyed my little rant. I'm getting more and more used to talking to the camera and showing up looking like myself instead of feeling like I have to do extra, because Vlogmas would not happen if I had to always make sure I was on point. But y'all know when I'm ready to pop out how I look, so it's all good. Because this is how I look now too, and she's cute. Anyway, I digress. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.